I'm showing you how to make homemade pumpkin puree from scratch with only one ingredient, the pumpkin. A lot of times you'll see these in the store. They're called baking pumpkins, pie pumpkins, sugar pumpkins. They're gonna be sweeter and the flavor is gonna be more concentrated. All we have to do is cut this pumpkin in half, take the seeds out, and roast it in the oven. I think in the past, people peeled and boiled their pumpkin. That is a lot more work and a more watered down flavor. So all we're gonna do is just cut this bad boy in half, just like you would a watermelon. The inside looks just like the big pumpkins that you use for carving. So I'm gonna scoop out the seeds, and then you wanna scoop out all that pulp on the inside. I'm gonna go ahead and warn you that homemade pumpkin puree is not gonna be as rich, deep orange as what you get in a can. Not exactly sure why, but I think it's because in the canning process, it gets cooked a little bit, and as the pumpkin cooks, it gets a little darker. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. For planning purposes, you can also expect to get the same amount approximately as you would in one can for one pumpkin. Okay, our pumpkins are scooped out and clean. Now we're just gonna bake them. You could do it just like I normally do a butternut squash and just roast them like this, flat against the pan. But I'm gonna stick to the recipe, which means I'm going to place them flesh side up, cover each one with foil, and bake them just like this. And now they just bake in a 325 degree oven for about an hour and a half. All the pumpkins are different sizes, so start checking it after about an hour. You'll know they're done when they're really soft. Once your pumpkin has cooked and cooled, all you have to do is puree it. You can tell it's done because you can see how tender it is. And now I'm just gonna scoop it into a blender. You'll wanna go all the way to the edge. Don't waste any. You know, pumpkin puree can be used for more than just pumpkin pie. But one thing I love doing is stirring some into chili. It just kinda adds a little delightful, I don't know, sweetness to it. If your pumpkin is really hot, you wanna make sure the centerpiece is out of your blender. It might need a little help getting started if you don't have one of those fancy blenders. Bringing me back to my new mommy days. Let's go make a good pie. Silky, velvety, flavorful. This is our homemade pumpkin. When it comes to storing your pumpkin puree, you just want to make sure it's in an airtight container. This can last for a week in the fridge, or you can freeze it for up to a year. So if you feel the craving, you know, hit you in June, you've got some ready to go. If you're looking to just use small amounts of pumpkin puree, if you're making a sauce or something like that, you can always just freeze it in ice cube trays. And if you want to make a big batch and freeze it, I would suggest dividing it among quart-sized plastic bags and stacking them on top of each other. So if you're ready to bake those pumpkin treats truly from scratch, start by making this homemade pumpkin puree.
That was fun.